We have while our video series 10 learned classification of loans and advances. One of the basis for classification of the loans and advances was deployment of funds. We learned that there are some credit facilities where there is a deployment of funds. Such credit facilities are called fund-based credit facilities. The examples could be term loan, cash credit, bill purchase, bill discount, etc. Similarly, there are certain credit facilities where there is no deployment of funds. The bank at that time gives only an assurance. Such credit facilities are called non-fund based credit facilities. Let us learn two mostly used non-fund based credit facilities called as guarantees and letter of credit. Today, by this video series 38, let us learn the non-fund based credit facility called guarantees. Guarantee is an assurance given by the bank to a third party for and on behalf of a customer to pay a certain sum of money if the person on whose behalf the guarantee is given fails one, either to perform an obligation, or two, fails to pay a certain sum of money under the contract. This is the definition given for guarantees. Now we understand that there are three parties in a guarantee. One is our customer, who is the applicant, for and on behalf of whom the guarantee is given. The second one is the bank, who is the guarantor. The third one is to whom the guarantee is given. He is called as the beneficiary. So in a guarantee, there are three parties. One, the applicant. Second, the bank as a guarantor. Third, the beneficiary. Now let us understand this with an example. There is a bank in a locality, and there the bank is having a garment manufacturer as a business enterprise. In that locality, there is a reputed school. The garment manufacturer concentrates mainly on stitching the school uniforms. The summer vacation has come and the new academic year is yet to start. The school wants 1.5 lakhs of uniforms for the students stitched within a period of 3 months. The school is willing to give the contract to this business enterprise, who is a garment manufacturer, subject to two conditions. One condition is the garment manufacturer should be able to execute the contract, say within a period of 3 months. That means he has to supply 1.5 lakh uniforms within a period of 3 months. The school is also willing to provide an advance of 25,000 rupees to the garment manufacturer, subject to the condition that the garment manufacturer utilizes the money only for purchase of the cloth to stitch the uniform. Now the school has to get these two conditions satisfied. For that purpose, the school will request the garment manufacturer to provide two guarantees from his bank. The first guarantee is that the bank gives an assurance that if he fails to complete the execution of the contract within a period of 3 months, bank will give a compensation to the school. The second one is, if the garment manufacturer does not utilize the advance provided for purchasing clothes or divert the money for something else, the bank has to give a compensation. So they expect two guarantees from the bank. So here there are three parties. One is the business enterprise, who is a garment manufacturer, who is the applicant. Second one, who provides the guarantee? The bank. So bank is a guarantor, party number two. And the third one is to whom it is given? It is given to the school. So naturally, school is the beneficiary. So we have three parties in a guarantee. Now you look here, there is a difference between the two guarantees which is sought for. Broadly, the guarantees are classified into performance guarantee and financial guarantee. Performance guarantee means guarantee which covers performance of an obligation is called as a performance guarantee. In this example, if you look at the, there is a performance. What is the performance? The garment manufacturer should complete the execution of the contract, that is, provide the uniforms to the school within 3 months. So that guarantee which covers performance of an act is called a performance guarantee. And the second one, what guarantee the bank provides is, if he doesn't use the money which is given for purchasing cloth properly, the bank has to give a compensation. So it covers payment of a certain sum of money. So naturally, the second one is called the financial guarantee. If you look at, there are various types of guarantees based on the nature or the performance. Let us understand what are the guarantees which are very prominent in the banking system. One is the bid bond guarantee. Second one is a performance guarantee. Third one is an advance payment guarantee. And fourth one is called the retention money guarantee. Let us understand all of these with the help of an example. We are aware that there is an authority called National Highways Authority of India Limited. Their job is constructing highways and constructing over bridges on the national highways. The NHAI wanted an overbridge to be constructed on its national highway between, say, Bengaluru and Mysore. Naturally, when they wanted to get the work done, naturally, they will give an advertisement in the newspaper calling for bids. That is, those contractors who are in that locality, who is interested in taking up this job, may submit their bids. So what will happen? Normally, the reputed contractors in that area will understand what exactly is the construction to be carried out, and they will submit a bid to them. Naturally, the one whose amount is the lowest, he gets it. There are two biddings. One is called a technical bidding, the other one is a financial bidding. In the technical bidding, the NHAI will only verify the capability of the people to construct the bridge, their reputation, past experience, etc. But in the financial bidding, they will look at who can do the job at the lowest price. Assume that in Bengaluru, there are 5 reputed contractors who would like to participate in the tender. See, when the bidding is to be done, there is a condition that each one of the contractor will have to give a security deposit to NHAI. That means, if you want to participate in the tender, naturally, along with that application, you may have to give some security deposit to NHAI. The very purpose of the security deposit is, out of the 5 contractors, only one contractor is going to get the job. So, having got the job, the contractor who got the contract awarded in his favor should not back out. If he backs out, he loses the security. So, the very purpose is, only those who are really interested in taking up the job, if the contract is awarded in their firm, should participate in the tender. That is the very purpose for which the security deposit is stipulated. Most of the time, what happens is the NHAI will say, there is no need for you to give hard cash to us. Instead of that, a guarantee to this effect, if it is provided by your banker, that is acceptable to us. So these contractors approach their banks and ask for a guarantee. The guarantee states that if the contract is awarded in their favor and if they don't move forward in executing the contracts, the bank will compensate them. This type of contract or the guarantee is known as bid bond guarantee. So bid bond guarantee is nothing but It is a replacement for the security deposit. It is to enable the contractors to participate in a tendering process. Now we have understood what is a bid bond guarantee. The second one, suppose out of the five contractors, one contractor got the contract in his favor and he has started moving forward. So naturally NHAI will say that, you know, the work is to be completed say within a period of 12 months. For that, they will again ask for a performance guarantee for its banker. The bank has to look at their performance, etc., etc., and then come to the conclusion that, yes, this contractor is capable of doing the job within a period of 12 months, and they give a guarantee in lieu of this. If the contractor fails to complete the construction, say, within a period of 12 months, the bank is prepared to pay a compensation to NHAI. Such guarantee is known as the performance guarantee. The moment he starts executing the project, the bid bond guarantee will be cancelled and the guarantee bond will be returned to him. He goes to the bank and get the guarantee cancelled. Now, in certain cases, what happens is NHAI organizations like NHAI, CPWD, PWD, they are willing to give some advance to the contractors to enable them to procure some raw materials like steel, cement, etc. There again, whenever an advance is given, the beneficiary will demand that the contractor provide a guarantee from the bank to support it, that he will not misuse the money given to him and it will be used only for the purpose for which it is given. If there is a misutilization, the bank will compensate them by means of a compensation. So any money or guarantee given against an advance payment is known as advance payment guarantee. Now, the last one is the retention money guarantee. Before the retention money guarantee, let us assume that the contractor who got the contract completed the work within the stipulated time of 12 months and the contract amount was for 25 crores and the contractor got an advance of 5 crore from NHAI. Now the work is completed in all respects. Now the contract amount is 25 crore and he received an advance of 5 crore, so the billing will be for 20 crore. Now the contractor submits his bill to NHAI that I have completed the construction as per the terms of contract and you may release payment for me. Now the NHAI will say that yes, you have completed the work, but we have not tested it. The testing will take 3 to 6 months time only when the traffic is on the overbridge. So they will say that we are prepared to release the funds only to the extent of say 90%. And balance 10% we will retain. We will release that fund only after seeing the satisfactory performance of the bridge, say for a period of 3 to 6 months. So what happened? My contract bill was 25 crore. Out of the 25 crore, they will say 2.5 crores will be retained at our end. Now I have to give you 20 crore, balance 2.5 crore. I will give you 17.5 crore. The balance 2.5 crore, you will have to wait for 3 to 6 months. When we find that the bridge is functioning satisfactorily, we will release that 2.5 crores. Now, what will happen? They will also tell them, we are willing to release the retained money of 2.5 crore also, provided your bank gives us a guarantee for 2.5 crore. If we find that there is something wrong with the bridge, naturally, your bank has to refund the 2.5 crore to us. This is known as retention money guarantee. So we have learned four guarantees. One is called the bid bond guarantee, which enables the contractor to bid for a work. Second one is the performance guarantee. It talks about the time limit within which the contract is to be completed. The third one is in lieu of advance paid, a guarantee which is known as advance payment guarantee. And the last one in lieu of the money retained, the retention money guarantee. Out of the four, except the performance guarantee, all others, say bid bond guarantee, advance payment guarantee, as well as the retention money guarantee, are financial guarantee. Now we have not completed the guarantee. We have to talk so many things about like onerous clauses, the limitation clause, the guarantee bond, how it looks like, and the counter guarantee, etc. then that we will see in the next video, series 39. If you have understood this, please press the like button and subscribe to this channel. And next video 39, we shall continue our discussion on the guarantees issue.